have not gone nuts. This is our beloved Star Trek uniform. Actually, it's Patrick one's, but I barely fit into it as well, and I really love it. As you might already know, we are quite space nerdy, and as this, Miriam, was your challenge with a space theme and all the Star Trek stuff, I thought I'd make it a fun video. I made your challenge. This is the result. Super cute, isn't it? Of course, I will not show you the end result yet. I will lead you along the way what I did, how I did it, what happened on the way, and yeah, just let you see how I tried to solve your challenge. Beam me up and address.
Black alert. Black
she
alert.
Tasks me.
Black
she
alert.
Tasks me. Black she really tasks me. Can I do it? I have done it before. But can I really do this? I look for materials around the moons of Nebia before I give up on her. In the very first steps, I just took some tape and taped the edges of my wooden frame here. This will prevent it to be smudged with paint or resin or glitter or whatever else could happen during my first steps. In the very end, when everything is done, you can just remove it, and if there was some paint onto it, it goes just with it. So this is a perfect and easy step to protect your outlines. My calculations show that continuing this challenge will cause failure at 59%, 60%. Are you sure you want to continue?
Space. Final frontier. These are the voyages of... This is phase number 2, which is creating the background. And to create this background, I used the Black 2.0, which I have tested just recently in another video, and I wanted to use it for this project as well, because I wanted to have the background as black as humanly possible and then start from there. As the background wasn't really taking the paint as good as I hoped to, I had to take 2 layers of the paint, and once everything was dried, I could continue with the scary and the fun part.
Captain, I did some new calculations. As it seems, by using this black, we will be able to create enough energy with our warp core to make this happen.
Once the background was done, the time came for all the details that you can find in space. And I like to work from background to foreground, so it was time to create the stars. This is, well, pretty simply done. And in my technique here, by just flicking the paint onto the surface, it is also quite quickly done. There are many ways to create your stars. You can just dot them, you can use a toothpick and dot them, you can just flick them as I did here. Or there are so many other different possibilities that I did not really come up with, but that you might have in your mind as well. Just use the method that you like the most. For flicking the paints, just thin down your acrylic paints a bit, but not too much. Then use a brush. These cheap little older brushes here work the very best because they are a bit stiffer. Put your brush into your paint and use your finger to flick it onto the canvas. You can also use a toothbrush if you like. Just make sure that you do not point towards you, because otherwise you will be sprinkled in paint. So just make sure that you point your brush towards the surface and then move your finger towards you. You can also create larger shapes like suns or moons or whatever you like to have in your space scene. And I also made a small galaxy, as you can see here. And I also used 3 different colors just to have some kind of variety into this.
Fascinating.
Once this was done and set aside to dry, I wanted to go on creating the planets. And there again are many different ways how you can create them. You can basically just, paint them onto your surface if you'd like to. But I wanted to stick to Miriam's method and poured my planets. As I'm not really a fan of creating these acrylic skins, as I tend to fail at those, and therefore decided to use some Yupo paper. It is relatively thin, so you might not be able to see it in the very end. It is waterproof, so it does not warp when there is a pour onto it, and it is just easy to handle, in my opinion. So I just grabbed some paint of the colors of the planet that I wanted to have, and as you all know, I really love the bluish tones. I decided to have my planet blue. To spice it up a bit, I also mixed some gold and some metallic pink to it. So paints were mixed, silicone was into them as usual, and then I ended up just basically making a swipe. You can of course use whatever method you would like to use to create your planets. This method also has the advantage that you will create these stripes and lines, which you are going to see on almost any of these gas giants. So those are created by the rotational forces that the planet has, and therefore by using the stripe method you can almost achieve a similar look. You can even increase this look if you do not use silicone for your pour as well and just swipe the paints so that you will not end up having so many cells or no cells at all. This is totally up to you, of course. I made two different versions just to see which one I will like the very most in the end and set it aside to dry. As this can only dry from above because the paper is waterproof, it really took some time until it was dry completely. I think it took finally 2 days to have it dried completely. I could not really do this outside in the sun because otherwise the paint would have cracked. And although this might have been working for such kind of a pour, I did not really want to risk it. Once everything was dried, tough decisions had to be made. I had to decide which part of the pour I want to use as my planet. After I figured out which part I liked the most for my large planet, I just cut it. You can use a ball or something like that just to create your shape, paint it onto your pour and just cut it out with a scissor. After playing around on the surface where I want to actually put my planet, I just found the perfect location and was ready to start with the background. And the background was something I was really looking for. Although also a bit scary, I wanted to use my airbrush again. I did have it for about a year now and only used it a couple of times, so this felt to be the perfect moment to use it again. And actually this is a very easy and simple step. I do have a stencil, as you can see here, with just some air bubbles, something shapes under it, which work actually great for underwater scenes and also works very great for space scenes because it just has some undefined shapes, which can in the end be a nebula or something like that. So I just grabbed my stencil and some of my airbrush paints, so a white, a blue, a red, a yellow, and yeah, just created some shapes, which already looked like a nebula structure thingy when I was done with it. If you need to correct things, it is no such of a deal. Just go over with black and you have your surface color again. And when I was done with the nebula, I just asked myself why I bothered so much having the darkest black in the first place, because not so much of the background black was left. So, but it looked great. And I was happy with the result. And just as a side note again, if you have areas where you have more paint than in other areas, so there is more contrast, it is no such of a deal, because you will cover everything with resin and colored resin anyways. So if there is an area, don't bother, just let it be. Also worth mentioning, when you have created your planets, do not forget to obey the rules of light and shadow. So if you want to have it looking three-dimensional, you will have to have a side where the light is shining onto it and a side which is laying into the shadows. So just make sure if you use an airbrush that you have one side lit up by using just a white and glazing over it and having one side darkened down with just glazing black over it. If you do not have an airbrush, there is no need to buy one. You can also use some kind of tissue paper or a sponge and just tap onto it gently. So you will have to use a couple of layers, I guess, to have a smooth transition area, but it will work the very same. The airbrush here that I'm using is just a more easy and quicker way to create this stuff. Probably you will not be able to get the exact same look if you do not have an airbrush, but it's a space scene, so it can look whatever you would like it to look, of course.
They call it resin. It is a two-component mixture which we have to combine and emit through our main reflector array to seal all the rifts.
As my Vulcan self already indicated, it was time for the first resin layer. And for this I used again my fast drying resin, which actually cures in about 4 hours. It is also the cheaper one. I mixed it, applied it onto the surface, and then I was ready to bring some more structure into the background. As I already knew that I'm going to need some different colors and pigments to create my space nebulas, I just used some smaller cups, took some of the resin that I've just mixed and poured it into my smaller cups. These will be used later on to mix my pigments in, with which I'm going to create the nebulas.
Captain, I have just returned from engineering. After cleaning the warp core, I have found quite many of these old dilithium crystals laying in there. We might be able to use them for your project as well.
Isn't that an awesome fun idea, just using these crystals? Of course, I was not allowed to use the dilithium crystals. I had to return them to engineering. But we had glass nuggets. We've just had some leftovers from them when some glass was broken after our last Borg attack, when 10 forward was hit, so they allowed me to use them instead. Thank you, Guinan. So you have seen me use them in different other projects before. This is just broken glass nuggets, which I've ordered from Amazon, where I get most of my stuff from. They come in different shapes and sizes and colors. I picked just some white ones, which is actually clear, and a soft light blue ones, which in my head made a perfect match for ice rings. Because I thought, wouldn't it be cool if my planet had rings? As it's a gas giant, most of them have rings, so I wanted mine to have rings as well. And you can see me apply them here onto my board, and it was just pretty simple. So everything was combined with the resin, everything was held in shape, and it just looked beautiful. And once the light was hitting it, it has these awesome cool sparkling effects. I really, really liked it. And time for another small side note. If you use these nuggets, you will see that the cut and broken edges are a bit matte, which is cool because it looks like a rock in the end. If you apply resin over it entirely, this matte effect is going to be gone. It will be crystal clear again, which I did not really want to have. So I have this happen on the smaller ones, which was just drowned in the resin, but I did not really want to have it on the larger ones, so I just kept care that they were bound with the resin from their downside, underside, bottom side, the side sticking into resin, and not having a resin layer over them just to not get rid of the matte effect. When it comes to the nebulas, I mixed some blue pigment, which is a cool metallic blue, a gold pigment, some white resin pigment paste, and some metallic pink acrylic paste into the small cups which I have set aside in the very beginning. Once this was mixed up, I started pouring it onto my resin layer, and it was still wet, so not cured. I used a straw to blow it around to make it look nebula-like and to bring it in shape where I wanted it to have. Realizing that the layer of resin that I've applied to my board was a bit too thick, so everything was a bit runny. It worked perfectly in the very beginning, but when I've seen the footage afterwards in this sped up version, I could just see how everything was flowing around. It was not really intended to do so. So as my surface was not as level, everything was a bit sagging up into the middle, and of course it also dragged the colorful resin with it a bit. So in my next attempt, I will see that everything is as level as I can, or probably just use the colored resin for the second layer when the first layer already is more level. But yeah, it is what it is. The final result is just great. So I'm really fine with it. And we are done. Can you believe it? We are done. Mission accomplished. One more layer of clear resin once everything was cured, and it's done. Now I've put it into the sunlight and want to show you the very final end result of it. So lean back and enjoy the tour. So, and that was the end result of this video and my video challenge from Miriam. I'm sure I get some new ideas to challenge you back, Miriam, very soon. And I really hope you liked it. It was really fun to make. I was really happy about the result. Thank you so much, Miriam, for challenging me trying this on my own. And if you liked this video, please make sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't done already. So thank you for your time. Thanks for watching. And until next time, have a great day. Bye-bye.
During the production of this video, I guarantee that no Vulcan nor other alien species was harmed. Live long and prosper.